acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Good light is the right light at the right time. This isn't Jesus' rhyme, nor spoken word refrain. The slogan comes from a global nonprofit in the Netherlands that educates people about the beneficial effects of particular light. Full spectrum light, sunlight, at the right hour of the day, turns out is beneficial to our brains and bodies. Enhancing human well-being is the mission of this Good Light group. And their tagline kind of rings for me like Jesus' leitmotif in today's gospel. You are the light of the world. It's catchy, succinct. Jesus might not be a slam poet, but his ideas have that kind of rhythmic quality, maybe even syncopated. You are light, light of the world, right light, right time, good light, earn right. The Good Light Group isn't the only organization to shine a light on modern-day disruptions to sleep, energy, productivity, human memory, mood, and mental health. These wellness concerns echo the world over. Whatever we feel, whatever stirs in our minds and bodies as we hear Jesus say, we are the light of the world, it's safe to say we all crave brightness right about now. Not just talking about all the rain we've had here on the West Coast. There's a need for light. We are given a luminous calling by God. The right time for Christ's light is always right now. And we reflect this sacred light in this present time. The source of the light, though, isn't us. It is the one who gives everything we need to embrace this holy calling. And the Holy Spirit ignites this good light in us. Light that's meant to shine not just for ourselves or our community, but light that goes out as a healing power in the whole world. God gathers us here, ignites us, and sends us out with that good light, the light of Christ entrusted to each and every one of us at our baptisms. And with that light, we are called to serve in the times and places where God calls us to be present. Now this morning, your brain and body might have wanted to shout out, "No!" in the middle of the gospel. Maybe not because you're resistant to Jesus' call, but you might have grown up singing that refrain. Anybody remember? "Hide under a bushel." No! I grew up with that. Maybe you did too. Maybe not. You might actually enjoy letting your light shine. I'm a little bit more shy. It's kind of hard to actually stand up here and say these things and say, "Hey people, we are the light." Feels a little bit pressureful sometimes. For me too. Well, I draw strength when I think about the fact that it's not something God asks me to do alone. And if you haven't seen this book, it is the history of St. Paul's. Now, it says from 1908 to the present, and when the time of the publication of this history, that meant, you know, up until the 90s. So it's actually a really good reading, but there's some missing pieces. There's been a lot of light since then, emanating from this block. Something fun about this book, and it's got beautiful colors, it's a very attractive cover, is the way that it lifts up the reputation that St. Paul's has had of being this pretty pink church on the corner of El Camino and Occidental. No, we aren't hiding our light. really glad that Sonic gave us a visual for this. Illuminating the whole house isn't just what we do in here when we light these candles or do the gospel procession. We have that presence there, symbolically telling us the light of Christ is guiding us in this journey. But it's also an opportunity that we have to cue ourselves, to listen to what the light is showing us to do. We return here week after week to nurture the light of love that Christ has given to each of us. Purple, pink, or every other hue in the spectrum. And we're not just meant to shine here, inside or on the block. God challenges us to go into wider pathways where we see God's light present and wanting to be ignited in the wider world. This naturally leads us to ask questions, to be curious about those connections between what we do here when we come together at St. Paul's and everywhere else we go when we're not here. Who do we know? Who does God connect us to? What does that teach us about what the world needs now? Yes, we return regularly to the body of Christ because this is where, when our light gets a little bit small or weak, we can replenish, we can renew ourselves, revitalizing our spirits, realigning our energies, listening for what God means when God says, there are ways that you should live, ways that will bring you health and balance and wellness, ways that will sustain you as you look to give yourself to love in all the ways it will ask you to serve. As we learn to understand our well-being as individuals and families and a community, as interconnected, conversations we'll have in March and May, we're going to continue listening and praying, discerning where God is awakening us to carry our lights, to partner with others in sharing God's power. Because love burns